Even though things were quiet on the outside of Water Tower Place, we learned quite a bit took place on the inside during today's early morning active shooter drill. Before 6 this morning, the barricades went up, blocking the driveways of one of the premier places to shop in Chicago, the Water Tower Place. The police department's SWAT team was inside preparing for an active shooter drill.
Overall, it was a success.
Alderman Brian Hopkins, whose second ward encompasses Streeterville, was there for the training exercise, and so were Water Tower security, district police officers, and civilian volunteers. 40 to 50 people participated in the exercise, simulating a person opening fire inside.
Some of the civilians who were involved in it, some of them just Water Tower employees, really got into it and they played the role. There were, you know, blood-curdling screams and people were acting as though this were really happening.
On the outside, we saw very little activity, no street closures, no perimeters, and people were allowed to come and go from the building up to the second level, which was the mall's food court. We did see the SWAT team practice their entrance armed and with shields.
For the SWAT team especially, there's really no substitute for actually being out there in the real world, dealing with real world conditions, fire stairwells, loading docks, back entrances.
Today's exercise was recorded and will be reviewed by all parties involved.
They'll make some decisions about what went well, what didn't, where's the areas for improvement.
Alderman Hopkins says these drills are usually discreetly performed in the early morning hours, but a decision was made to alert the public after confusion ensued earlier this summer during a drill that the public was not made aware of.
One person will see it, not realize that it's a drill, tweet it out or put it on social media, and within minutes, hundreds of people panic.
Alderman Hopkins says today's drill lasted about 90 minutes. From the Water Tower Place, Courtney Gooseman, WGN News.